So we have a lot of research coming out from the trauma field that looks specifically at what the school's role might be, because they have so much time and opportunity with children and youth to be able to teach those things, both through practice and modeling. You can have direct teaching of those skills, and you can just be modeling them yourself day in and day out. And that overlap of teaching techniques is huge, it's critical. One of the first things that you always want to do is to create that sense of safety. When people are living in survival mode, feeling safe and having a place and an environment that helps them regulate the way that they're responding in the world is primary.
I've actually, since I first started teaching, what has transformed in my practice was I started with the space. And I realized the power of an influence space has. So in my classroom space, it is very soft. So I have my own lighting, cushions, quiet spaces, areas for kids to go to that they have to calm down. And it's a place that kind of feels like when you enter that you're going to someone's home. And that was, it's a powerful message without saying a word. And so when they enter the space, they're kind of like, oh, this feels safe. It feels soft. And I think really good things are going to happen in here, because it's a completely different feel than maybe a traditional classroom would be. And on the walls, I don't put all the teacher decoration up. It is completely on the voices of the children. So when they enter, they're basically, the message is that you belong here. And it's your voices that are up here. It's not my space, it's our space. And it's the beginning of a conversation about being a classroom family. I may sound like I lead a lot, but that's just because I'm an elder in that family. But really, your voice is just as important as mine.
So there's videos, there's research articles, there's all kinds of opportunities to learn from other people and other schools and other teachers, other environments where people are doing really good things. There's a movie called Paper Tigers, for example, that takes an example of an alternative school in Washington and really does a lot of teaching with the students directly around ACEs and what that looks like, and change that school environment. And the stories of success from individual students as well as the whole school community are just astonishingly positive. And I know we have examples like that of individual classrooms, individual students, individual teachers, as well as districts, whole school communities doing just equally amazing work, but we don't necessarily share those stories all the time. So looking for more platforms to share strategies is really critical.
One or two things that have been really effective with our school population is working one-on-one with students that have the most extreme responses to stress, and giving them the language and the understanding of what they're going through when they're triggered and they can't manage themselves.
So being trauma-informed very much looks like teachers and educators and anyone in the school district simply knowing what trauma is, what it looks like, what the symptoms are, what the red flags are, and then having a direct referral resource to reach out to and say, I have this kid, this is what I'm seeing, how do I provide them with help? And that's generally what's happening currently with our organization and the school districts that we're directly working with. We get phone calls of whether it's admin, teachers, whoever it is that sees these warning signs, they connect with us and we come in and we provide trauma-specific counseling to the youth that they're seeing show these symptoms.